So hey guys, it's Vijay from HP Games. For many laptop buyers who like gaming, the promise of dedicated or discrete graphics is like a pizza with full toppings. In 2017, Nvidia launched its amazing GPU MX150. Not dedicated graphics card for gaming laptops, but it can certainly provide an enjoyable experience with some of the most popular games. But the latest report from Notebook Check indicates that not all MX150 are born equal. And performance across all the laptops with this GPU varies drastically. So why Nvidia did this and how you can find out the difference? In this video, we will be discussing about the same, and before we start, I would recommend you to share this video with all of your friends who are planning to buy a new laptop for gaming. And do subscribe for more videos like this one. Few days back, Digital Crony asked this question. I bought a laptop with MX150, but it's not performing the same as you shown in your videos. What's the problem and how to resolve it? So Nvidia launched the MX150 dedicated laptop GPU in mid-2017. It's an architectural improvement over its predecessor 940MX GDDR5 memory. It's based on Nvidia's GP108 chip, which uses the Pascal architecture. Nvidia claims that its new mobile GPU is up to 66% faster than its predecessor 940MX and 3 times more power efficient. That's why you may have seen series of budget gaming laptops with this GPU. But as per the article by Notebook Check, Nvidia has been sneaking in slower GeForce MX150 variant onto some ultrabooks. Evidence has shown that Nvidia is manufacturing two different versions of its MX150 mobile GPU. The two variants of MX150 GPU IDs, 1D10 and the 1D12. Basically, these names reveals absolutely nothing for consumers. But one of these offers significantly reduced performance than the other. The 1D10, also known as G1A1 variant, is a 25W TDP chip with a clock speed of between 1468 and 1531 MHz. On the other hand, the 1D12, also known as LG A1 variant, is a low TDP 10W chip with a clock speed between 936 and 1037 MHz. In some cases, the 10W chip has up to 25% less performance than standard 25W chip, which has 1D10 in the device ID. So Nvidia is making this low-powered MX150 GPU specially for laptops with low power supply, longer battery backup with very slight gaming abilities, or maybe to save rooms on some slim ultrabooks. The problem for consumer is that Nvidia and its laptop partner aren't making it very clear about the variant of the MX150 which include with each laptop model. So for consumer, both the GPUs are look alike. For example, you can clearly see on the image that both the GPUs are based on GP108 chips. Both uses GDDR5 memory and works on 14 nanometer chip size. Only difference is in their device IDs. I personally think that making a low power GPU is not a bad thing, but not declaring it and naming it with the same name of a famous GPU is not a good, especially with a company like Nvidia. It's a huge and very respected company. Anyway, they are making few tons of dollars with miners purchasing their GPUs for mining. The bottom line here is that if you are in the market for a laptop with an MX150 inside and want the best performance possible, then dive into the technical specification and check specifically which variant of the chip is being used. It must be the 1D10 chip ID. Yes, of course, if you have battery life in first position of your list, then you may go for 1D12 chip. I'm mentioning some of the laptops with slower versions of MX150 as per the site Notebook Check. Make sure to check these variants if you want any specific gaming laptops, or else you can go for other GPUs also, like 1050 or 1050 Ti for more better performance. So that's it for now guys, hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new today. Make sure to hit that like button if you like it and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.